But that's what happens as you get older. All your conversations change. When you're in your 20s and 30s, you talk about girls and fast cars and movies and stuff. Then you get to 40, 50, you start talking about politics and sports. Then you get to my age at 65 and older, and all your conversations are about medical issues going on with you. I don't care how a conversation starts, it'll somehow come around to somebody's colonoscopy. It's like, yeah, our grandson's playing soccer now. Well, did I tell you about when the doctor had me in that room there for a little bit? And then everybody piles in. And I hate that. That's all my friends and I talk about anymore is how many pills were taken, what pills are we taking, what did the doctor say you could or couldn't eat? And God forbid somebody gets rushed to the hospital for emergency surgery. Then we become like witnesses at the Amber trial, Johnny Depp trial. You know, we're just like... Well, then what'd he say? What'd he say? Because you know what's next. It's going to be you, so you want to be ready, right? We have a friend who's a little bit older than us, and he swears he had a heart attack, but he didn't. But we keep asking about it because it's so fun to hear him tell the story. Because he becomes like a war hero in a Ken Burns documentary. It was Tuesday, 0700. I had just driven through the Hardee's drive-thru, got a bacon, egg, and cheese biscuit. When my heart was under attack. I reached for my cell phone, but I knew communications with my left arm had been cut off, and I knew that the nearest hospital was 7 clicks away. And that's when the panic set in. I remember screaming, "You're not taking me, Charlie!" Then he asked his wife, "How was Joe's heart attack?" He said, "Oh, he didn't have a heart attack. He gets gas every time he goes to Hardee's." Then he calls me screaming, "I'm dying, I'm dying." And by the time I get home from the Walmart, he's asleep on the couch. And we're all like, "So?" But that's what happens as you get older, man. It's like, oh my God, this is how bad it's gotten. This happened today. I had to put my glasses on to help me get my contact lenses in. And COVID wasn't just all about medical issues either. COVID had forced a lot of us to reevaluate our marriages. I know where you are, I'm one of them. My lovely bride and I have been married for 40 years. Thank you. But let me tell you something. The reason we've been married for 40 years is because I go away. I often tell her I'm the perfect husband. I go on the road, pick up a check, come home, drop it off, leave again. But COVID hit, and now we're together 24/7, and we had a little adjusting to do. I learned a lot about Gail that I didn't know. You would think after 40 years of marriage, I'd know everything there is to know about that woman. But I learned a lot. I learned that she's addicted to Bed Bath & Beyond. And I think they ought to call it Bed Bath & Beyond Your Budget. She just buys crap. One day she came in and she goes, "We need to go to Bed Bath & Beyond." I said, "For what?" And she goes, "I need to get clothes hangers." I said, "Don't we get them free from the cleaners?" She goes, "No, I need the special kind, and you ladies will know what I'm talking about." She said, "I need the kind with the velvet on them." I said, "For what?" She goes, "So it keeps my dress from falling off." I go, "That's been our problem for 40 years. My other favorite was, she goes, "We need to go to Bed Bath & Beyond." I go, "Now for what?" And she goes, she said, "I need to get guest towels." I go, "For what?" She goes, "So when people stay with us, Bill, they have towels they can use." I said, "Well, here's a thought. We have a washer and dryer. And those folks don't live with us, so they don't know that our regular towels ain't our guest towels. And if they bitch about it, screw them, they can go stay at the Hilton." I said, "You're just buying crap." She goes, "Well, you buy crap at Bass Pro Shop." I said, "No, ma'am. I buy essential items at Bass Pro Shop." She goes, "Like what?" And I said, "Like, I need a cooler that knows whether to keep my beer cold or my coffee hot. That's essential." She goes, "You're an idiot." I go, "I'll be an idiot with a cold beer. That's what I'll be."